Hello, my dear students. Today I want to teach for final year BCom, that is fifth semester BCom, a subject called costing methods. This subject is for 70 marks for theory and 30 marks for internal marks. The chapter name is contract costing. This is a very simple chapter where you can learn very simple way. What is contract cost? Contract is generally we have a construction industry, how the contractors prepare their account. Say, usually contractors prepare an account called as a contract account in order to show how much profits they have earned in each of their job undertaken for construction. So that means we have to prepare a contract account which is prepared by the contractor. Who is a contractor? Is a person who undertaken a job of constructing a building or a canal or a bridge or anything. So he wants to know how much profits he earned. So therefore, in order to know how much profits he earned, how much losses he incurred, we prepare an account called as a contract account. So I will be solving 3 years question paper, that is from 2017, 16 and 15. Okay, first we'll take 2017 question paper. So I have written a question. From the question paper only I have extracted here. So I'll read out the question. The following particulars relate to a certain contract carried out during the year to 31st of March 2017. What is given is work certified. What is work certified? Work certified is the certificate issued by the architect for the work completed by the contractor. Because the contractee is a person who is a landlord, he will not believe the contractor how much he has done the work or how much he has not done the work. So therefore, contractee will appoint, the owner of the land will appoint an engineer, an architect to certify how much work is done by the contractor. So that is the reason after the work is completed, the architect will issue the certificate. That's on the basis of the certificate, the contractee will decide how much money he has to pay to the contractor. All of you got it? So that is what we call it as a work certified. And cash received from the contractee. You can make a difference here. The work is certified by the contractor. The architect is 1,43,000, but cash paid by the contractee is only 1,30,000. That means there is a difference of 13,000 rupees where the contractee is not yet given to the contractor. I will tell you why the reason. Because if the contractor is paid full amount of work certified amount, he may run away from the in the middle of the work. So therefore, the contractee will hold some money, that is called as a holding money or retention money. We call it as a retention money. Next is material sent to site. See, generally, when I am a contractor, what are the expenses for me in constructing a building is materials. And what is next is labor. I incur certain direct expenses. I incur some office expenses or establishment expenses. So when I am preparing a contract account, see, I will read the question part of the question and we'll try to solve the answer also. So we prepare a contract account. In this contract account, we have debit and credits. Okay. So this is your contract account. Say debit all expenses and losses. Whatever the expenses are incurred, I will show it in the debit side. Now, just now we read materials at site means at site I have 64,500 rupees and labor incurred for me to complete this portion is 56,600 and plant is 11,300. Installed plant at the end. See, when I installed the plant, its value was 11,300. Now at the end of the year, the plant at the end 8,200. See, you can take 11,300 year and deduct plant at the end 8,200. Remaining amount will be what? Depreciation. So when you using any asset, the value of the asset will come down. That deduction value or reduced value, we call it as a depreciation. Now, cost of work not certified. See here, work certified is given, work uncertified is given. So, this is will be a part of the account called as work in progress account. See, under the work in progress, we come across with work certified. What is the amount of work certified is 1,43,000, and work uncertified, work not certified is 3,400. Then establishment charges 3,250, and direct expenses or direct charges is 2,600. Materials on hand at the end, see, total materials we at site beginning was 64,500. At the end, 1,400 rupees of material is laying at the site. So materials on hand at the end is 1,400. And some of the materials we returned to the stores. See, these were the materials we brought from the stores at site, and materials, some part of the materials we are returned to the stores. Returned to stores. That is around 400. What is next is given is contract price. That means the contractor is undertaken for a price of 2 lakh rupees to complete a given job or a given construction work. This 2 lakh rupees is a total contract price, but the contractor is completed only 1,43,000 rupees of work, which is certified by the architect or an engineer. But here he is not completed. So this type of contract is called as what? Incomplete contract. Whenever there is an incomplete contract, we need to take the totals first. That's all the points we have covered. If you check, credit side is more than debit side because it is almost all showing 1,50,000 plus. So totals will be 1,56,400. The difference, 1,56,400, credit here, put it here, deduct all these things, I get the profit. This profit we call it as a notional profit. Why we call it as a notional profit is the contract is not completed. See, contract price was 2 lakhs, but certified was only 1,43,000. He is yet to complete the work. Therefore, the profit, we don't call it as a net profit. We call it as a notional profit that comes to 18,150 rupees. Now, this is carried down and brought down. Sir, why we need to carry it down, brought down? It is very simple. Since the contract is not completed, the contract is incomplete, a part of the notional profit should transfer to reserve also, and remaining amount we have to transfer to profit and loss account. First, how much we have to transfer to profit and loss account? See, there is a formula for this. See, first, notional profit into 2/3 into cash received divided by work certified. That means, why I am telling is, if the work certified is more than 50%, equals to or more than 50% of the contract price, you can transfer 2/3 of profit to the profit and loss account. What happens if the less than 50%, 1/3 should be transferred to notional, I mean profit and loss account. Very simple. If it is less than 50%, then 1/3. If it is equals to or more than 50%, 2/3 you can transfer. Now 18,150 into 2/3 into cash received is 1,30,000. I am taking only 1/30 divided by 143. 1,43,000 I have taken 143 because 3,030 cancel. You get exactly 11,000 rupees. How much? 11,000 rupees you have to transfer to profit and loss account, and remaining amount, how much? 7,000 remaining amount you can transfer to the reserve. Why, sir, we have to transfer to reserve? Very simple, guys. Reserve, why we have to transfer is because the contract is not completed, and always we should be in a reserve position, because yet the work is to be completed. We may incur certain losses also because of rise in materials, rise in labor. So therefore we transfer to reserve a portion. All of you understood, I hope. So I'll be getting back to you in the next video of 2016 question paper. Okay, bye. We have one more question in contract costing. which is asked the year 2016 for Bangalore University for 6 marks. Say, what we have done in 2017, the previous problem, similarly, the same problem is there, but very simple, very clear. Say, when you are preparing, he is asked just to prepare a contract account. First, take a rules for contract account. So, as I told you, debit side of your contract account will have expenses and credit side of your contract account will have incomes. So, now, if you take a contract account like this, first let us read the contract price. Do we require for contract account? It is not required for us. Next is what? Raw material. So, material, labor, direct expense is a major expenses for contract costing. So, we write materials or raw materials is 1,20,000, and then wages or labor, wages or labor is 1,60,000. Then subcontract cost. Say subcontract cost means what? Say when you are constructing a building, a builder cannot do every job, right? You may be given electric work to somebody else for a subcontract. So he is given 5,000 rupees like that. Subcontract cost is a 5,000 rupees for him. And the plant, see here, plant we purchased and installed in the contract place or in the outside 20,000 rupees. And materials transferred to the other contract. See, material transferred to other contract is something material returns. So you brought materials to the site 1,20,000 rupees. From that, you are returned 2,000 rupees of materials to where? To the other contract. So when we have transferred materials, transferred to other contract is 2,000 rupees. Next is general expenses is 7,600. So we have taken all the expenses and all. Now at the end of the year, cash received from the contract was 2,40,000, being 80% of work certified. See, in the earlier problem, we have the problem itself, there was a work certified. But in this problem, he is not given the work certified. What he is telling is, if you complete 100 rupees of contract work, he will give, the contractee will give you 80 rupees of cash. And the remaining 20 rupees or 20%, he will retain, that we call it as a retention money for the guaranteed money that contractor should come back and complete the work, rest of the work, right? Now, what he is telling is 80% only is giving cash, but we don't know what is the amount of work certified. Now, for this, what we have to do is work in progress. First, let us take a work certified. How to calculate work certified? Is given 2,40,000 rupees. Is given 2,40,000 rupees cash received, which is being 80% of work certified. Means, if the work certified is 100 rupees and he is giving a cash of 2,40,000, which is equals to 80. What is for work certified is 3,00,000 rupees, because 8 ones are 8, 3s are 24. We can easily divide it. Okay. Now, so 2,40,000 is cash received being 80% of work certified. What is for 100%? So we have calculated 3,00,000 rupees. Now this portion is over. Now value of materials unused at the end of the year is given 18,000. At the end of the year, materials unused is 18,000 rupees. Anything else is there? Yes, plan to be depreciated at 20%. See, I told you in the last problem, it was not given this. It was a mistake in the question. But in this question, clearly given depreciation is 20%. See, plant, how much we use? 20,000 rupees. So, what we can do here is depreciation on plant, or else plant at the end. See, beginning we had 20,000 rupees and depreciation we used for 1 year completely. 20% of that 20,000 rupees will be 4,000, and 16,000 will be the closing balance of the plant, which we have to take it in the credit side. Now, if you check the totals here, 10, 16, 1 carries, 2, 3, so 3,36,000, 3,36,000, and if you check the totals of this, you get 400 and I think 23,400 rupees. So 23,400, this will be the notional profit. I told you very clearly, why we call it as a notional profit? Because the contract price is 6 lakhs and the work certified is only 3 lakhs. It is exactly 50%. If it is exactly 50 or more, we need to transfer 2/3 of this notional profit to profit and loss account. So this is called notional profit brought down, 23,400. I told you, if it is exactly 50% or more than 50%, equals to or more than 50% of work certified on contract price, then we need to transfer 2/3. So 2/3 to transfer 23,400 into 2/3 into cash received is 80 rupees and work certified is 100 rupees. Cash received is 80 rupees and work certified is 100 rupees. Now, if you check the this thing, almost we get 12,400 rupees. 12,480 rupees we get. 12,480. So, this is the amount which we have transferred to profit and loss account. So, 23,400 to 1 carries, 5 plus 19, 3 plus 0 and 10,920. That is 12,480 transferred to profit and loss account, 10,920 should transfer to reserve. This will be the balancing figure. So, this is how we need to transfer, we need to prepare 2016 question paper, how to solve for 6 marks. So here, very important point is, first one is, he is not given work certified directly, we need to calculate. Second one is, depreciation is to be calculated. See, we can show depreciation in one more way also. Instead of writing plant, you can write directly depreciation on plant as 4000, so that we can eliminate two entries. If you are writing beginning, then you have to write ending minus the depreciation. Okay. So, I hope all of you understood. If you understood this chapter or this problem, and if you want more videos to upload, please subscribe my channel Sai Study Circle, and don't forget to press bell icon, and you can share to your friends also so that they can also learn. Thank you so much, and see you in the next video.